Good morning, students. I hope you all are fit and healthy at home. Myself, Jyoti Nahar from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group, and I'm going to take class 6 science. And the chapter that we are going to take today is chapter number 10, motion and measurement of distances, video part 2. In our previous video, we did introduction, story of transport, that is I told you how the evolution of the vehicles that we are availing today came into existence. Concept of measurement, what is the need for measurement in our daily life activities, how our daily life activities, they gave rise to measurement. Traditional methods of measurement, that is ancient times people used to have the traditional methods of measurement, that is hand span, cubit and fathom. Standard unit of measurement, that is the standard units that are used today, like for length we have meters, for temperature we have Kelvin and so on. Correct measurement of length, how to take the correct measurement of length, how to place the ruler, how to place the correct position of our eye. This was all done in the previous video, that is video part 1. Now in this video, that is video part 2, we are going to discuss the types of motion and combination of two or more motions. Now let us start. Before starting, let me tell you some important terms, or we are going to discuss some important terms that we will be using in this video, that is motion. What is motion? When the position of a body with respect to surroundings changes with time, the body is said to be in motion. Or we can say that an object is in motion if its position changes with time in relation to a stationary object. That stationary object may be a building or a tree. Examples: motion of a car or a train, motion of heavenly bodies like satellites, planets, stars, and when we are running, jumping, all these undergo motion. An object is at rest. Now what is rest? Rest, if it's an object is at rest if its position does not change with time in relation to a stationary object. As we compare a body with a stationary object, if its position is not changing, then we can say that the body is at rest. Like when we are sleeping, when we are standing, when we are sitting, when a bottle is kept on a table, we say it is at rest. Measurement. What is measurement? The comparison of an unknown quantity with some known quantity of the same kind. That known quantity may be a standard unit. Now let us start with the types of motion. We have different types of motion that a body undergoes, like translatory motion, rotatory motion, rotational motion, oscillatory motion, vibratory motion, periodic motion, non-periodic motion. And this translatory motion is further subdivided into two kinds, that is rectilinear motion and curvilinear motion. Now we are going to take these types one by one. Firstly, we'll do translatory motion. What is translatory motion? If all the parts of the moving object also move through the same distance in the same interval of time as the whole object is doing, this type of motion of an object is known as translatory motion. And what are the examples? We can say when a train is moving, we say all the parts are moving at the same time and in the same distance as the whole train is moving. This has two kinds. Rectilinear motion. When is rectilinear motion said to be done? When an object moves in a straight line, it is said to be in rectilinear motion. Example, when an apple falls from a tree, or when a car is moving in a straight line, we say that it is rectilinear motion. Now next one is curvilinear motion. When does a body undergo curvilinear motion? If any body moves along a curved path, when it moves through a curved path, it is said to be in curvilinear motion. Example, when a stone thrown up in the air at an angle, if we throw the stone at an angle, or a bus when it is taking the turn, we say that it is undergoing curvilinear motion. Now, sometimes what happens, a body does not move in a straight line even, or in a curved line. It moves in a haphazard manner, means no fixed direction is there. Then the body that moves about in a haphazard manner in all directions is called random motion. Examples of random motion are motion of a house fly, butterfly, or the ball in a football or hockey game. It undergoes haphazard motion, so we say that it is random motion. Next one is rotational motion. When is rotational motion done? The motion in which a body moves about a fixed axis without changing its position is called rotational motion. Any body, when it undergoes movement about a fixed axis, then we say that it undergoes rotational motion. What are the examples? The motion of blades of a fan. You can see the blades of a fan, they are moving in rotational motion. If I mark a point on the blade of a fan, you will see that the point moves about the fixed, at a fixed distance from the axis, that is the center of the fan. Again, hands of a clock, they are also undergoing rotational motion. Hand blenders, blade, and rotation of the earth. Coming next to oscillatory motion. To understand this oscillatory motion, let us do a simple activity. We take a thread and tie a small stone at one end. Now hang the thread so that the stone is hanging loose. Now observe the position at this point. After this, we give it a gentle push. What do you observe? You observe that the stone, it moves to and fro from its mean position. So we say that this to and fro motion of an object about its position of rest. What was the position of rest? This is the position of rest, and when the stone moves to and fro about this position of rest, we say that it is undergoing an oscillatory motion. And the examples, motion of the pendulum of a clock. You've seen clocks, we have pendulum in it and it moves to and fro about the mean position. So it is undergoing oscillatory motion. Motion of the swing. When you give a gentle push to the swing, it moves to and fro about the mean position. So that is also an example of oscillatory motion. Now next one is vibratory motion. Again, you can understand this by a simple activity. Take a rubber band and tie it between two supports so that it remains stretched. Now when you pluck the rubber band, when it is in the stretched position, if you pluck it gently, what happens? You see that it vibrates fastly. This to and fro motion of an object about its position of rest, again this movement is faster, and in which some points do not move at all, some points which are near to the support, they may not seem to be vibrating. So this type of motion is known as vibratory motion, or we can say fast or rapid oscillatory motion is called vibratory motion. When the oscillatory motion is fast or in a rapid movement, we say that it is vibratory motion. And the example, we can say string of a guitar. When we pluck the strings of a guitar or sitar, they undergo vibratory motion. Now coming up next to periodic motion. Periodic motion is the motion which repeats itself after a certain fixed period of time, and this period of time is this fixed whenever it is moving around the body again and again. is called the periodic motion. And what are the examples? Examples may be rotation and revolution of Earth. You know that the Earth completes one revolution around the Sun in 365 1/4 days. So this time period is the same always. Maybe we may consider a leap year as a different case, but it is in the same period. Or we can say when the Earth is undergoing rotation, in the rotation movement we see that the Earth completes one rotation in 24 hours, and this period, time period, is same when it is rotating along. Motion of pendulum of a clock. Again, this motion of pendulum of a clock, this takes the same time period. So again, it is periodic motion. Needle of a sewing machine. You must have seen the needle of a sewing machine. It moves about it moves in a certain fixed time. So it is also called periodic motion. Next one, non-periodic motion. When it is not periodic or the certain fixed period of time is not fixed, we say it is non-periodic motion, or a motion that does not repeat itself after fixed interval of time. The motion is not repeating itself after a fixed interval of time, or that interval of time in which the motion is repeating may not be same. Then we say it is non-periodic motion. Examples are, when we ride a bicycle, when we are riding the bicycle, what happens? The motion of our legs is repetitive. Means we are riding the bicycle, or the motion of our legs is repeating, but it may or may not be at regular intervals. So we can say that it is a non-periodic motion. Now coming up, sometimes what happens, we have a combination of two or more motions. Means a body may undergo two or more motions at the same time. In some situations, the motion of an object may be a combination of two or more above mentioned types of motions, like that we did. An example of this is motion of a ball on the ground in a straight line. When the ball is moving on the ground in a straight line, we see that here the ball is moving about an axis. The ball is moving about an axis, and the axis itself is moving along a straight line. Means the ball is moving, rolling on an axis. So it is undergoing rotational motion. Again, when the ball is moving in a straight line, we say that the ball is undergoing rectilinear motion. So thus the ball executes a rectilinear motion as well as rotational motion. So this was an example of a combination of two or more motion that we studied earlier. So this was all about the types of motion that we did, and I hope you must have understood both the videos, part 1 that is we did about measurements, and part 2 that we did about motion and its type. So now it's time for you to get into motion. Stay healthy, stay safe. Thank you.